feature engineering, data transformations, ATL, data pipelines. If you've ever heard these terms and wondered what the heck they were, this video is for you. So if you put 10 data scientists in a room and ask them to define data science, you wouldn't get 10 answers. You would probably get 20 or 30. And there's a lot of reasons for that. Mainly where data science is a interdisciplinary field, and data scientists, we all come from very, very different backgrounds. For example, somebody that comes from, you know, an economics or statistics background like myself, social sciences, is going to look at things and solve problems a little bit differently than somebody that comes to the field from, like, let's say, computer science or engineering. But in general, this is kind of how I think of data science, or how I would define it to people. And again, maybe not everybody's going to agree with this, but I think most would. We take raw information that exists in the world, and from that information, we generate actionable insights. So there's several different steps to getting from raw information to actionable insights. You're probably all familiar with, you know, modeling and building an AI model. I mean, that's certainly something that data scientists spend a lot of time doing. Also deployment, you know, getting it, you know, consumable, and then, you know, actually getting the insights from the model once it's deployed. That's kind of the whole point. But one part that I don't think gets quite the attention that it deserves is this part right here. Going from raw information to transformed information. And this is what we call feature engineering. And again, sometimes it's called data pipelines, sometimes it's called ETL, sometimes it's called variable transformation or data transformation. But those things might be mean something different in other contexts. But in the context of data science, they all pretty much mean the same thing. It's the process of taking raw information as it exists in the world and transforming it into in a way that it maximizes your AI model's ability to predict. So what does feature engineering look like? What kind of feature engineering would a data scientist do? Probably the most common one is something that we call dummy variables, or sometimes it's called one-hot encoding. But this is a situation where you have a variable that is a category. For example, yes, no, yes, forms like that. Text like this or a category like this, a lot of times the AI model doesn't really know what to do with it. Of course, it depends on the model, but a lot of the models that we use really can't handle text information. So one way that we'll transform it so that it's usable by an AI model is we create these things called dummy variables. And a dummy variable is just taking one column of data and splitting it into multiple columns. So the original variable was yes. So the new column we've labeled yes is going to be 1. The new column that we've labeled no is going to be 0. Likewise, the column that's labeled no is going to be, or the row that has a no value in the first column is going to be a 0 for yes and a 1 for no. So the idea is you take the original categorical variable and you spread it into multiple numeric variables, and that's easier for a machine learning model or an AI model to consume. Another thing we'll do sometimes is we'll take an original variable and we'll transform it by just taking, you know, the natural log. Sometimes we'll take an original variable and we'll take the inverse. Sometimes we'll take two columns in the data set and we'll multiply them together into one new variable. These are all little things that you can do, and a lot of times, and again, the point is that you're trying to transform your raw data so that it gives you a more predictive model. With documents, it's a little bit different, but the idea is basically the same. I mean, with documents, you've got, you know, something in a PDF form or some kind of text file. And one way you may transform a text file is to summarize it. You know, maybe you want to use an LLM or some kind of text function instead of ingesting the whole document into a model. You just extract a summary. Maybe you want to go to the document and extract key features from it, like, you know, the people involved, the businesses involved, and use that in an AI model. But again, whatever you call it, the idea is that you're taking raw information and you're converting it into something that's more useful to build your AI.